Hi, this is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about fixing STL errors. In Magics, you can do fixing in three different ways. You can do automatic fixing. You can use the FixWizard, which is the semi-automatic fixing tool. And when needed, you can use the manual fixing tools. The autofix option will usually take care of all the errors in a part and save you time and effort. You can either enable autofix during import, or you can apply it once your parts are imported. All you need to do is import your part. Go to the fix ribbon and click on autofix. With a single click and in a few seconds, all the critical errors will be fixed. We have two remaining overlapping triangles, which are non-critical errors. Normally, the fixing algorithm of Magics is able to fix these errors as well, but the errors on this part were intentionally created for demonstration purposes. Later in the video, we'll see how we can manually fix such errors. Let's undo the automatic fixing. Next to the autofix button in the fix ribbon, we have a fix wizard button. The fix wizard is a semi-automatic fixing tool that gives more control and flexibility over the fixing process. As you open the wizard, the first page you will see will be the diagnostics page. On this page, you get a complete overview of the errors in your STL file. You can click on the update button anytime to rerun the diagnostics. At every step of the fixing process, the fix wizard will give you advice on what to do next. If you click on follow advice, the advice displayed will be applied. If you wish to intervene in a fixing step, you can go to the page for the relevant step and either automatically fix that type of error or use the manual tools available. Let's go back to diagnostics. The first advice we get is to use the combined fix. Combined fix is similar to automatic fixing. But here, you can choose to leave out certain fixes, for example, hole filling, to do it later manually if needed. Once it's complete, the advice window will tell us what to do next. So let's go back to diagnostics. All the critical errors have been fixed, except for two non-critical overlapping triangles. Let's continue following advice to the overlaps page and try fixing them. Apparently, these triangles cannot be fixed by the algorithm. If the algorithm cannot fix this error, then we can use the manual tools. For this, I'm going to click on Detect Overlapping. And here are our overlapping triangles. I'm also going to change to triangulated view. To fix this, I'm going to go to the Move Part Points tool in the Fix ribbon. I'll grab the corner of this triangle and bring it in line with the rest. Let's do an update on the status. Perfect. Our part is fully fixed and ready to be printed. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.